Hello, thanks for visiting graphicillusion.com. This is quadrant number 5. And I also have number 6. Here's Star Reach number 7 by Barry Windsor Smith. The quadrants, I think, are by Husu, with really good art. Here's an autographed Warped number 5 by Frank Brunner from First Comics. Here's a Glow in the Dark Max number 1. These are rare and unique items. This is Shadowhawk number 2, gold. Here's Supreme gold number 1. Make offers for these. Brigade number 1 in gold. Printing. These are unique printings. Sax and Violins, Platinum Edition, Heavy Hitter Epic, which is Marvel, number 1. By Peter David and George Perez. Here's one of the rune things. If you got all the rune comics, then you got this big giant poster made by them. Here's Rai, number 1. Or Ray, depending how you say it. Darker Image, number 1. Unique, gold, silver embossed. An autographed Warp, number 2, by Frank Brunner. $35 at least. Platinum Predator versus Magnus Robot Fighter, number 1. Here's a never before out of the publisher bag, Spider-Man number 1 by McFarlane. You had to send away to get these, and comes with a certificate of authenticity usually. I can tell you more about that if you inquire. Graphicillusion.com. Put a dash between the graphic and illusion. There's Gambit, an X-Men character. And this is a number 1. It's a gold. These are like pristine mint. I got them, I put them away, and now you're looking at them. Green Hornet number 1. Free limited collector hologram card, unopened, still sealed in the publisher bag. Here's a gold Spider-Man 1. These aren't necessarily valuable, but I've sold a ton of them for $5 to $10 a piece. And they are unique. It's a second printing Spider-Man. I have plenty of the first printings. Here's Jack Kirby's Secret City Saga number 0, tops, gold, rare. Here's Beeman with seriously great art, probably with people like Williamson, Al Williamson, who did EC Comics in the 1950s. Here's Unity number 1, gold, platinum, or silver, depending how you look at it. RoboCop versus Terminator, Dark Horse, platinum. It says platinum right here. Here's a Spider-Man number 1, first printing, still in the publisher's pre-sealed bag, a Marvel comic by McFarlane. Here, Frank Brunner just signs this little piece of paper at an autograph party I threw for him at Ninth Nebula, the complete comic book store, which I had open from 86 to 96. And, wow, can't believe it's been that long. Here it is, 2007, 11 years later, and I'm still selling comics. Unity, number 1, time is not absolute. This is a gold Unity, because of this gold right here. These are rare and unique. Overstreet cannot price them correctly. There's a nice silver Spider-Man number 1, still sealed in a publisher bag. Because they're so unique, the print runs are very small. Here's a Max number 1, autographed by Keith. There's the autograph right there. Here's a Savage Dragon and a Savage Megaton Man. They verse each other. They're verses. It's an Image comic. It's gold. Here's a nice X-Men number 117. I think another X-Men 117 by John Byrne, most likely. Magnus Robot Fighter 1. These are like part of my personal collection, but if you want to buy them, let me know. Frank Brunner's autographed Warp number 8 from First Comics. Frank Brunner's work was really great. He made Doctor Strange great too. First Comics, Warp number 1 by Frank Brunner. And here's a Warp number 9, autographed. X-Men number 124, probably by Dave Cockrum. Here's something called Lynch Mob. It's autographed. I'm sure it's number 1 and rare. 1994 Jensen. Can't see the number on it. From Chaos Comics. Here's another Image comic, Young Blood, gold, zero. And here's Razor Zero. Probably from Chaos, but I'm not sure. Anyway, take care. That's a nice little group for you to look at and consider and ponder and consider buying. Thanks for visiting graphicillusion.com, graphic-illusion.com, where the comic books keep on rolling. They never end. We've got a lot of comics here. Okay, take care. We're gonna have to put every single one of them on YouTube. Why not? Take care.